So that video was paused due to some reason. Now I am moving ahead. So we were discussing about the chromosomes, how the chromosomes lead to the formation of a baby boy or a baby girl. That was sex determination. Sex determination. Okay, so as the male contains XY chromosome, where the female contains XX chromosome. Here, these chromosomes, one chromosome will get in one of the gamete, X and then Y. These are the gametes being produced. Here, female will produce only X type of eggs. Means 100% of the eggs will contain 100% of the eggs will contain X chromosomes. Okay, while 50% of the sperms will contain X chromosome and 50% will contain Y chromosome. Now, after the fusion, it will fuse with this one, so a baby girl will form. Baby girl. With the fusion of this, again the baby girl is formed. With the fusion of this Y chromosome with this X, a baby boy. Then the fusion of this with this, again a baby boy is formed, and that is how sex determination is there in human beings. Now coming to the implantation, the next topic. That is implantation. As soon as the fertilization occurs, the zygote is formed, that is diploid, and in the zygote, cleavage and mitotic division starts. So two process occurs in the implantation during after the fertilization. First is cleavage, and second thing is mitotic division. It means it is equal division. This is the egg. Mitosis. After mitosis and the cleavage, the zygote converts into the two cell stage. Like this is the ovum. It occurs, means the mitotic division occurs. After mitotic division, it occurs in two cell stage. Inside it, two cells are formed. Okay. So it is two cell stage. Then it divides again. Now the four cells are formed. Four cell stage. Okay, and that is how it will start continuing. 4, then 16, 8. 8 cell stage. So that is how it keeps on dividing, and then 16 cell stage. However, the zygote size will remain same. The all over zygote size will remain same. The size of the inner cells, these cells will get reduced. 16 cells. Okay, this is 16 cell stage. The 16 cell stage is known as morula. What will we call it? This is what? The morula. And zygote at the ovum at the ambulary isthmic junction, it is being fertilized. So it keeps on moving down. Here it is. Let's say this is the oviduct and this is the uterus. This is the lining. Here the fertilization occurs. Okay, so it keeps on dividing and here it keeps on moving also till it reaches the uterus lining here. Okay, so at this side, it will, when it comes to morula, then it converts into, after morula, we have to remember the 4 to 16 cell stage, it is known as morula only. Then it converts into blastula. Or you can say blastocyst. So in the blastocyst, it is one important term, blastocyst. Blastocyst contains the outer layer, outer cells. Okay, so these cells are trophoblast. This is trophoblast. And some of the cells are also present. This is known as inner cell mass. Or you can say ICM. From now we will call it as ICM, that is inner cell mass. Further, this cavity is known as blastocoele. This cavity is known as blastocoele. So this is the cavity known as blastocoele. Coele comes from word coelom. Coelom means cavity. So blastocoele is there. So this is also the characteristic feature of a blastocyst. In other animals, it is known as blastula. While in human being, it is known as blastocyst. This trophoblast gets interdigitated with the wall of the uterus and here the implantation occurs that will lead to pregnancy. Here, for the first time, the pregnancy is being attained. When the trophoblast gets attached to the uterine wall. The trophoblast will lead to the formation of placenta. Placenta is one tissue that provides nutrition to the developing embryo, the function of placenta. Trophoblast, it provides nutrition to embryo, rather developing embryo, you must say. Okay, developing embryo, trophoblast, while the ICM, it will develop into the organs, develop into fetus. Okay, so organs are being formed from the ICM, whereas trophoblasts lead to the formation of placenta. Now coming to the next thing, one more important thing is left, all these cells present in this, we are calling them 2 cell, 4 cell, 8 cell, 16 cells. So these cells are known as blastomeres. So these are blastomeres. Okay. So that is about the embryonic development or the implantation. Okay. Now important thing come here about the placenta. Placenta. The diagram of blastocyst is very important. Many questions have came from blastocyst. Trophoblast is again important. Now coming to the function of trophoblast. the trophoblast, it convert into, it converts into placenta. Okay, now the role of placenta. First of all, it provides nutrition. To the developing embryo, it helps in exchange of nitrogenous waste. Exchange of nitrogenous waste to and from the mother. Okay, means from the fetus, the excreta is being removed from to the mother and then from the mother to the outside. Okay. Now, the important thing about the hormone. Placenta also plays an important role in endocrinology. Means it is also an endocrine gland, you can say. So, it releases some hormones. Okay, endocrinology, endocrinal hormones are being released. One is HCG. HCG means human chorionic gonadotropin. Human chorionic, it is chorionic gonadotropin. Okay, so it is HCG. This is also used for testing the pregnancy. This serves as the basis of pregnancy because for the first time after the implantation, placenta is formed and placenta releases this hormone, that is HCG. So it serves the basis of testing of the pregnancy. So HCG is one of the important hormones and it also supports the pregnancy. Along with this HCG, other three hormones are also released. That is, one is HPL, then estrogen and progestogens. And the second one is HPL, human placental lactogen. Human placental lactogen. Then progestogens. Progestogens means all these hormones are being released from the placenta and estrogen. Okay. And the estrogen. These are released in the early stage of the pregnancy. While at the later stages of the pregnancy, one more hormone is also released. That is released from the ovary and that is relaxin. From ovary. Please mention it. These are of the placenta. These hormones. These are released at the early stage. Then from the ovary at the later stage of the pregnancy.